and all, my name is Rio and welcome to another Matchday vlog. So today, Chester FC play Kidderminster Harriers away, where we look to record our first away win of the new season. So football is back today because for the very first time this campaign we have had a full week off. So it's really good for us because it's gave us time to reflect on our start so far. And I think we have started off really well because so far we are still yet to concede an opposing goal from open play. And also we haven't lost a single game so far, so hopefully we can buck the trend today and get another win. So we have got a fully fit squad for the first time in a while today because we have a lot of strength and depth, so hopefully we can field a really strong side today and come home with all 3 points. So it will be a tough game today, but Kidderminster have had a bit of a up and down start, so hopefully we can capitalise on that and get our first win at Agbury for the first time ever. So yeah, I can't wait for the big match today. I have been to Kidderminster twice, but I just can't wait. So of course I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please like, subscribe and comment down your thoughts on the match below. So without further ado, let's get into today's video right now. Enjoy. Let's rewind back to last Saturday, where we picked up a fantastic 4-0 win at home against Gloucester City. So I thought it was a really good performance, and for a while we have been craving for a 90 minutes performance, but it is fair to say we did deliver really well last Saturday because I thought both in defence, in midfield and in attack, and also in goal, we were very clinical, we were superb in every single department, and we fully deserved a win because we were 2 goals up after just 5 minutes. So we got off to an unbelievable start because Danny Livesey scores an absolute worldie in the first minute, and it was just inside the opposing half, so it was from about 45 yards out, so it was an unbelievable goal. So make sure to watch the highlights, which are in my matchday preview, to see that goal back. So we made it 1-0 after just a few moments. Then a few minutes later, George Wehrman scores a 1-on-1 to make it 2-0, so we were absolutely flying at that stage. And in the first half we won loads of headers in both defence and midfield. Russ Griffiths made some superb saves, and up front Matty Hughes and George Wehrman, they were absolutely superb. So yeah, first half was very good performance. The second half was just as good because just a few minutes into the half, Brad Jackson made it 3-0, so it was a great goal because he scored a rebound. So initially Matty Hughes, he had a shot which was saved by the Gloucester custodian, but thankfully Jackson was on hand to score the rebound. So once again, another good goal in front of the Harry Mack. And just before time, Akwasi Asante scored a penalty to make it 4-0, and it was his second penalty in the matter of days, because just a few days before that one, he scored the equalising goal away at Kettering Town. So Akwasi Asante is fully fit now, so hopefully he will get another goal today, because he did score against Kidderminster last campaign away from home, but unfortunately we lost 4-1 that day. So yeah, I do have I am quietly confident that we can beat Kidderminster today, because although we must be happy with a draw, I think we need to go the full extra mile now. I think we need to get more wins away from home, because we have played 2 away matches so far. We have drew both of them, but I just think now we need to try and go for the league title, because I think the playoff places would be really good, but we just need to try and cement a place in the top 7, because every match is very important now. We are currently 6 matches in, so it's vital that we do get at least a draw today. I think a draw would be good, but I just think a win would be even better, and it would give us loads of confidence, because don't forget we have got another match in just 48 hours time, because on Bank Holiday Monday we have Hereford FC at home. So they've made a really good start to the season, so once again we have got another tough game, but I just think if we get a win today, then hopefully get 2,500 on Tuesday, on Monday at home against Hereford, then thankfully we should be really good. So yeah, it is going to be a tough one today, but we have got a fit squad now. Hopefully we can come home with all 3 points. Will take 2 hours to get to Kidderminster, so I have been there before twice, and it is a fairly straightforward journey, but on both occasions we've been woeful, because my first visit was back in 2017, where we lost 2-0 away in the Emirates FA Cup 4th qualifying round, and in my opinion that was our worst performance in the Marcus Bignett era, because we were disgraceful that day. It was diabolical, and it was a bit of an embarrassment, because at the time we were actually one league above Kidderminster, so it was a bit of a cup Cup shock then a few months ago. So back in February, my second visit was where we lost 4-1 away at Kidderminster. So once again, it was an awful horror show, but hopefully this time out it will be third time lucky, because on both occasions the food has got the better of us. Because I must admit, the food at Agbu is unbelievable. The pies they do are just insane. So make sure to get a pie before the game today, because they will be of high demand. But hopefully our performance will be better than the pies, of course, because we will be looking to get that elusive away win today. So yeah, it's a nice stadium. So Kidderminster play at Agbu and it holds 6,444, so it is a really nice stadium for this level, and in my opinion it is one of the best stadiums in this league, because it actually looks a little bit similar to our very own Diva Stadium. I think it's got a bit of a similar layout. So yes, so on one side you have the Reynolds stand, which is a covered all-seater stand, and it's quite a nice stand, and also the dugouts are actually built into the stand. So the dugouts are actually very close to the supporters, so it's a bit like the dugouts at Old Trafford, if you've ever been there. I've never been to Old Trafford, but I have seen some photos, and yeah, the dugouts are built into the stand. Opposite that is the East Stand, which again is another covered all-seater stand, but it is actually a bit bigger than the Reynolds Stand, so you can get a decent view there. Behind one goal is the North Terrace, which is a covered terrace, and you can make a good atmosphere there. And finally, behind the other goal is the South Terrace, and once again it is a covered terrace, but it has got a bit of a segregation cage halfway through the stands, which I think separates the home, separates the away supporters from something else really. So today's match will be segregated, so we will be allocated part of the South Terrace North, and we will have a small section of the East Stand too. So I think we'll take a good following today, because whenever we played Kidderminster away before, we've taken at least 400, so hopefully more of the same today, and hopefully come home with a big 3 points. So it should be a great atmosphere for you. I have actually looked at the weather, and it actually says 28 degrees today, so it is going to be very warm today. So yeah, I'm going to should be a great day out today, so looking forward to it now. Hopefully we'll come home with a big win. Kidderminster Harriers have had a very inconsistent start to this new season, because on one hand they have a really good away record, because they have beaten Curzon-Ashton 1-0 away, and also a few weeks ago they beat Bradford Park Avenue AFC 3-0 away. But on the other hand, their home form is actually quite bad, because on the opening day they only drew 2-2 at home against Leamington, and last Tuesday they actually lost 3-2 against Gloucester City. So they were 2 goals up at half time, but somehow Gloucester scored 3 goals in the second half to win 3-2. So yeah, they have had a bit of an inconsistent start so far. So in my opinion, I think we are playing Kidderminster at just the right time, because they are still trying to find their feet, because during the summer they did undergo some new management, because John Pemberton arrived from Chesterfield, and this will actually be his first ever full-time gig as a first team manager, because he used to be the academy manager at Chesterfield, but he's never managed a first team before. So it will be very interesting to see how he does adapt this season. But yeah, so far they have picked up some decent results, but on the other hand they have picked up some very embarrassing results. I say the Gloucester game, they should have beaten them. So yeah, it should be a good game today in Kidderminster. They have got some decent players, the likes of Ed Chambers and also Richard Pennicutt, who I did mention in my matchday preview. So they have got some good players there, and they have had a few issues off the pitch as well, because as we speak, Kidderminster are currently undergoing a change in ownership, because a few of their supporters aren't too happy with their current chairman, Colin Gordon. So they are expecting to have some new owners in the coming weeks and months too. So things are going a bit, you know, shipshape at Kidderminster. So it might be one of those seasons where they just have to consolidate, because they are a big club, Kidderminster. They shouldn't be at this level, but yeah, last campaign they just finished outside the playoffs, and they actually finished below us. But yeah, I initially thought that Kidderminster would do well this season, but so far they haven't really convinced me, so it could be a season of mid-table for me. We have played against Kidderminster quite a few times before, so it has been a tale of two halves, because we haven't lost a single match at home against them, but on the other hand, we haven't won a single match away from home. So hopefully we can put that record straight today and get our first away win. So our last match against Kidderminster was back on the 9th of February 2019, and we lost 4-1 away. So as I said before, it was an awful display, because Akwasi Asante actually made it 1-0 to us just before half time, but after that we just went into panic mode, and we conceded 4 goals unanswered. So it was an awful second half, so hopefully we can put that right today and get our first ever win away at Agbu. My score prediction for today's encounter is Kidderminster Harriers 0, Chester FC 1. So for the Seals, I think George Waring will score for us. So he did used to play for Kidderminster a couple of years ago, so I do think he will score on his return to Agbrys. So yeah, I think it might be one of those matches where it could be a scrappy game, because I think it might be a decent game, but I just think it will be very close. And Kidderminster, they have got a nice flat pitch there, so we have no excuses today. They have got a very nice playing surface, so I think it's going to be a decent game today, but just could be one of those where I think our quality will get the better of them, because we have got a decent defensive record, and also up front we have scored quite a few goals already. So I think it will be a good game today, and hopefully we can come home with a big 1-0 win, I think. As ever, I will be going to the match today, so of course stay tuned for a match day vlog which will be coming up right now. So of course I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please like, subscribe and comment down your thoughts on the match below. So yeah, come on City, this will be the first time I'm going to be wearing this new polo top today, so hopefully it will be first time lucky, because last week for the Gloucester game I wore that third shirt for the very first time, and thankfully it was a very good luck charm. So hopefully this will be another good luck charm today. So yeah, come on your blue. We can do this, cannot wait, come on. Have now arrived at Agbrys, so yeah, once again it's a fantastic day here. The pitch looks superb and I think it's really nice stadium. So yeah, as I said before, this will be my third visit here, and on both occasions we have been dreadful, but hopefully the sun is out and hopefully we can deliver. So yeah, should be a great game today. We're taking a really good following, two full coaches but many more on the trains and on the cars as well. So yeah, you know, it's looking really good, the place, and we really like the stadium. So yeah, I can't wait for the match, and hopefully we can come home with a big win which will extend our unbeaten records. So yeah, can't wait. Come on, you Blues. Here is your Kidderminster Harriers squad for today's match. And here is your Chester FC squad for today's game. So we are in a 4-3-3 formation. In goal is number 1, Russ Griffiths. In defence is 2, Kevin Roberts. 5, Danny Liberty. 6, Simon Grand. And 3, Joel Taylor. In midfield is 7, Brad Jackson. 4, Captain Gary Roberts. And 8, Gary Stopforth. And up front is 9, George Waring. 10, Matty Hughes. And 11, Anthony Dudley. On the substitutes bench is 12, Scott Burton. 14, Aquasia Sante. 15, Matty Waters. 16, Danny Elliott. And 17, Craig Mon. So enjoy the matchday vlog. Up the Seals. Come on, Brad. Oh, we're lucky, Brad. Come on! You have a corner. Yellows! 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 Brad Jackson tried to get the crossing, but Kitty cleared it away in the other corner. So Gary Roberts is going to take it on the far side. So it's gone in with a goal mouth scramble. Shot by Brad Jackson was blocked by Kitty. Very close there. Well, oh, we're lucky. Crossed by Joel Taylor, got cleared away. Another decent spell there.
Io City, City Io.
Come on, Dubs. Oh, no. So unlucky by Dudley. Shot by him went wide. All he had to do was take a touch. Oh, that should have gone in. So unlucky. Russ Griffiths has just made a fantastic save to deny Kidd in midst of their play. Was 1-1, but he stuck his leg out to make a superb save. Could have been 1-0, but thankfully Russ saved us. It's going to be taken any moment now, so hopefully we'll get a goal ahead. So yeah, I think so far we've been really good. I think going forward, Brad Jackson has been superb, and I do think we have been a better team. Go on, Gary. Oh, come on, Matty! Oh no! Ever so close again. What a clever move that was. Come on, City! Come on, City! Gary Roberts plays Matthew Hughes in, and he tried to... his shot went just wide. It was so close. Oh, no! Another cross went in. Keeper catches it. Yellows! Yellows! Joel Taylor was just being clipped on the edge of the area, so we have another free kick, and Christ, that would play some lovely one-touch stuff. Oh, we're lucky, the free kick was saved by the goalie. Yeah, the free kick went in by Roberts, but the keeper made a decent save. But yeah, so far, playing really well. We are on top, and we should be at least 2 goals up. Hopefully keep it going now.
Brendan Jones, do you want me? Brendan Jones, do you want me? Brendan Jones, do you want me?
Come on! Oh! Oh no! Come on now, City! Come on!
Yellows! 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 Yellows!
A cross by Kevin Roberts went in, and Kidderminster, their defender, nearly scored an own goal, but it just went clear, so yeah, that was another great chance there.
was Matty Hughes. He scored from a tight angle. 1-0 now, and we deserve it because we've been all over Kidderminster today. And as we speak, there is a flare by, but who cares? 1-0 now. Hopefully don't blow this lead away. Hopefully keep going now and get a few more. Come on, City! Come on! We are now halfway through the first half here at Kidderminster, and it is now 1-0 to the Blues. So I think we've been superb so far, and we played some brilliant stuff, even at times played some one-touch football. It's been really good today, and there should be about four goals up, actually. We are the Chester Bulls. Come on! Yeah, so sorry about that, got interrupted, but yeah, there should be about three, four goals up, because Anthony Dudley, he had the chance for about a few yards out. He should have scored, and it went wide. A free kick by Gary Roberts was saved by the keeper, and not so long ago a cross by Kevin Roberts should have gone in too. But yeah, we just got the opening goal a few minutes ago. It was Matty Hughes, so that's his first goal back since his return. It was a great goal, nice one-touch football. So yeah, playing really well.
Come on, City!
Come on, City! Yes, yeah, so far playing some really good stuff, and hopefully keep it going now. So yeah, come on, Blues. Time, Kidderminster Harriers 0, Chester FC 1. My words, we've been superb once again today. We've been fantastic, and we should be about 3 or 4 up in my opinion, but the main thing is we're still winning, and yeah, we've been really good today. So yeah, we should be a couple of goals more ahead, I think, because as I said before, a shot by Anthony Dudley went wide, and a free kick by Gary Roberts was saved by the keeper, and again Matty Hughes and Kev Roberts, but you know, they had two good chances which went just across the face of goal. But yeah, so far so good, and I think really you know, going forward we've done really good, played some really good stuff, because we played some nice one touch football. Matty Hughes, George Ware, and they've been superb, and Brad Jackson, Kevin Roberts going forward. The midfield, we have been a little bit, you know, thin, but still I think we have done really well. Kidderminster, they haven't been poor actually. They had a bit of a decent spell for the last 10 minutes, but I just think now, get a few more goals second half, this would be fantastic, because we always do awful here. We never win at the stadium, but hopefully things will change today. And as things stand, we are actually second in the table, so yeah, hopefully more the same second half. So yeah, looking forward to the second half. Come on, you Blues, come on.
Come on, City! Come on, City!
Russ Griffiths has already made a decent save. The opening attack of the second half was Kidderminster, and they had a decent chance in the area, but thankfully Russ Griffiths got down well to save the ball. Matty! Oh, a header by Matty, what a huge hit, just went over. It was a losing back to his head, but went very close to going in. Oh, unlucky. Come on! Went in by Brad Jackson, but Kidderminster clear it away, so we have a corner on the far side. The corner's been taken short by Roberts. So Joel Taylor, oh no, well, lucky the cross went in. The kiddie keeper fumbled it initially, but he just recovered at the last second. By Dudley was blocked. Oh no, how did he miss that one? Brad Jackson, the shot by him went scuffed by. Oh, they should have buried that one. That was bound to go in, but he just scuffed it wide.
Burnley's on us, do my homie.
Halfway through the second half and it is still 1-0 to the Yellows, so I think Kidderminster have been a bit better in the second half. I think they've had more of the ball, but still we have been quite composed and comfortable. We just had a chance a few moments ago, shot by Brad Jackson as well, but yeah, I think, you know, we're still doing well to hold on. I think defensively we've been good. Kidderminster are trying to get back into the game, but still we've been quite good, so need to try and get up the pitch now a bit more and try and go for the second goal. And here's George Waring. Go on, George. Go on, George. Keep going now. Keep it in, George. Well played. Oh, well played, George. George Waring kept the ball in. Sponsor Jacko. Oh, no. Kidderminster gets it away, but yeah. Hopefully we get another goal, but if not, hopefully hold on and get our first ever win at Tagbury since 2005. Come, you Blues. Duds, have a shot. Oh! I thought he went in for a split second. Anthony Dudley went very close to getting the second in. His shot went into the side net. A few fouls of balls and started to cheer, but hit the side net. Yeah, very close to 2-0. Kidderminster Harriers 0 Chester FC 1. My word, what a win getting there. It was a fantastic display, and in my opinion that is our best away performance for quite some time, so this is a real statement. So yeah, fantastic win. Hopefully the trip home should be great and I can't wait. So yeah, on to Hereford on Monday now. So yeah, can't wait for that one. So yeah, what a win. Come you Blues, more reaction very shortly. Come you Blues.
Shining happy people laugh.
Kidderminster Harriers 0, Chester FC 1. So my word, I'm so happy because for me, this is our best away performance for quite some time, because last campaign we only won a handful of away matches, but other than that we were quite woeful. But today it's just a fantastic result, because Kidderminster, it's always a tough place to go, because prior to today we have never beaten Kidderminster Harriers away since 2005. So that is a massive 14 years ago, so thankfully we broke that up today. So it's a great result for, we fully deserved to win today. I don't think Kidderminster, I don't think they were too bad. I thought in the second half they did give it a good go, but I just thought over the course of the 19 love was fantastic display, and this ensures our unbeaten start to the new season. So I've been really impressed with how things have gone for us so far, because we are now third in the table, so things are looking very good for us. And over the course of the summer a lot of things have improved, you know, in regards to our squads, because one, our energy is just unbelievable. Our energy is sublime, because obviously last campaign we had so many injuries, but now we have a fully fit squad, and today it really did show, because whenever Kidderminster had the ball today, which wasn't too often, we pressed them so hard and it caused them to panic. So yeah, Kidderminster, they were in panic stations, and it did force them to just rush the ball up, you know, in some periods. So that has really impressed me over the course of the summer, especially the likes of Matty Hughes and George Waring and Anthony Dudley. You know, they were pressing Kidderminster's backline really well today, and that did cause them to panic. Also, we were actually scoring goals, because the last campaign we did score quite a few goals, but on some occasions we did struggle to find the net, and this season we have scored quite a few goals. And also, number three, we were actually stopping goals from going in, because once again we kept another clean sheet today. So we have now kept two consecutive clean sheets, and also we are still yet to concede an opposing goal from open play. That is a staggering stat, and so far 6 matches in, we are yet to concede an opposing goal. So if we hadn't have conceded those 3 own goals, we would actually be top of the league. So it is quite hard to believe, but it is true, it is facts. And yeah, we are actually doing really well defensively. I thought Simon Grand and Danny Livesey, I think they had their best games of the season today, and I thought they did really well. So yeah, it's a fantastic display. We fully deserve to win today, and it's just great to get that first away win of the new season, which should give us loads of confidence. So I thought in the first half we were superb. I thought we were dominant, so we were by far the better team, and yeah, we got off to a really good start. So we did have a few chances in the opening moments of the game, because Anthony Dudley, he had a chance, he missed a sitter actually, because he was only about 6 yards away from goal. It was a bit of an awkward one, but still he should have scored on another day, and on another day I'm sure he would have scored. Gary Roberts, a free kick by him was saved by D. Kidderminster, the custodian. A chance by Kevin Roberts went so close to going in, because we got to the byline, he played across, but sadly no one could quite get to the ball, so the ball just whistled away from the goal line, so it could have been a goal. So yeah, we had some really good chances, and also Kidderminster, they had one or two. Russ Griffiths, he made a really good save to deny Ed Williams on one occasion, because it was a one-on-one situation, and Ed Williams, he was about to go through on goal, but Russ Griffiths, he stuck his foot out to make a fantastic save. And also Milan Buttersfield, he blazed over from the opening stages as well. So yeah, Kidderminster, they had one or two chances, but they weren't too great in the first half, and I thought we were superb, and we actually made it 1-0. So thankfully our hard work paid dividends, because we were all over Kidderminster for the opening 20 odd minutes, and we had loads of chances, but you know, just wasn't to be. But thankfully Matty Hughes had other ideas, because it was a great move, nice one touch football, nice ticky tacky football, and it was a great finish by Matty Hughes. He just slotted it home into the far corner to make it 1-0 to us. And also this was his first goal since his injury back in 2018, because of last year, because obviously he got injured against Hereford FC, and funnily enough we play Hereford FC at home on Monday. So yeah, it was his first goal since his return, so I'm really happy for the lads, because last weekend when it was his first match against Gloucester City, he had loads of chances, but sadly it just wasn't his day. But thankfully he finally got that elusive goal today, and hopefully he can score even more goals for us this season. So yeah, Matty Hughes scored a great goal to make it 1-0. For Kidderminster, for the last 10 minutes of the first half, I thought they played better, but you know, in general we controlled the possession. We played some really nice stuff. Brad Jackson and Joel Taylor going forward, they were superb. Kevin Roberts, he was solid at the back, but even going forward he was excellent as well. And I thought first half couldn't ask for any more really, we should have been a couple of goals more up. Yeah, second half, must admit, I thought that Kidderminster were a little bit better. I thought we were still in control, but Kidderminster did have a few decent spells because the opening attack of the second half was by Kidderminster, and it was Ed Chambers, and he had another chance, which was thankfully smothered by Russ Griffiths, who made an easy save to get down. And we had a few other chances too, because a looping header by Matty Hughes just went over the crossbar onto the roof of the net, so he could have got his brace. And again, we had a few more chances because Anthony Dudley, shots by him went into the side netting, and some of our supporters actually started to cheer because it did look like it went in, but sadly it never. And also Brad Jackson, he fired wide as well, so yeah, you know, things started to go thick and fast for us. Kidderminster, he had another chance though, and it was an absolute, I can't believe it didn't go in, because Russ Griffiths, he took the goal kick and it ricocheted off Ed Williams, and my word, he was about 5 yards away, open goal, and somehow he blazed wide. It was an unbelievable miss, and that was a huge lifeline for us, but thankfully, you know, that just saved our day, because from then onwards, we just saw out the game, and we got a massive win, and this will be our first away win of the new season. So yeah, it was a superb display today, and we played some really nice stuff. My man of the match is Matty Hughes, because obviously it was his first away match today since returning from that really lengthy injury, and he was superb. He was, you know, pressing Kidderminster's backline really well. He was very energetic, pacey, and now that he is fully fit, that, you know, that's a huge plus to us, because last week against Gloucester he did the same thing as well. He was pressing their backline, and it caused them to panic on a few occasions. And also George Waring, he held the ball up, excuse me, really well, and he's really good in the air as well, because he won a lot of headers. He wasn't lucky to not have scored, but who cares, we won today. Thought defensively we were superb once again. Russ Griffiths, he kept his second consecutive clean sheets, and he made some really good saves as well. He did have a few time wasting tactics, but who cares, because we won today. I thought Simon Grant and Danny Livers, he has said at the start of this match report, I did say that it was their best performance of the season so far, because they made some really nice interceptions, and also they won a lot of headers too. Joel Taylor, it was his first match up to Kidderminster today, because obviously he played for Kidderminster last season, so it was his return, and I thought he was fantastic once again going forward. And also his long throw-ins into the box, they were fantastic as well, and they worked really well too, and he was really good once again, Joel Taylor. He hasn't played a single bad match so far, so hopefully he can do more of the same. I thought Kevin Roberts, once again, he was solid. He stopped a lot of the crosses from going in, and also going forward he was quite quick as well, because he did have a few spells in the first half where he made some decent deliveries too, which sadly just couldn't find anyone really, especially the one which went just across the face of goal. That was very unlucky, because, you know, if someone had got to the end of that ball, that would have been right into the back of the net. And also in midfield, I thought the two Gary Stott, four fans, Roberts, they were sublime once again. Gary Roberts, he made some fantastic passes, and also he broke up the play really well in the middle of the park. He did have a bit of an injury in the second half. I think one of their players got his ankle late on, but he did play the rest of the match, so I think he will be okay. I thought Stopforth, he was superb once again. Covered every single blade of grass, and also he broke up the play really well too. And yeah, I thought that was it really. So for us, it was a great display once again. But also today, the momentum is certainly creeping in a little bit, because we've played 6 matches so far and we haven't lost a single game. And also our atmosphere was sublime today. We took just under 400 supporters today. Our atmosphere was just fantastic, non-stop singing throughout the game. We really need to keep it up now, because as I say, we are 3rd in the league now. And I know we're only 6 matches in, but still really good, because in my opinion, August is our toughest month of the entire season. And if we can go through the Hereford and spend more matches without losing, then that'll be an unbelievable start, because at the start of the month we would have taken 15 points, and so far we've got 12. So if we just get enough of 3 points out of our next 2 matches, that'll be, you know, really good for me. So yeah, can't say any more really. Superb display. Need to get 2,500 or more on Tuesday on Monday against Hereford. So yeah, cannot wait for that. Our next match is against Hereford FC on Monday, so of course it is Bank Holiday Monday, so both us and Hereford have got off to some really good starts so far, because Hereford, they're 4th in the table, so yeah, they're just one place below us, and they held Brackley Town to a 1-0 draw today, so that's a decent result for them. And I do believe Hereford, I have been told that they might be taking a lot of supporters. Some of their supporters are saying they might take 1,000, so that would be unbelievable really, because Hereford, it is quite a journey. It's about 3 hours away to a 4,000 on the bank holiday Monday is just superb. So hopefully get around 3,000 there. Hopefully we'll have a few more supporters going to this one, because obviously we won today, so hopefully a few more would be, you know, inspired to go on Monday. So hopefully have around 2,000 home supporters and maybe around 1,000 away supporters, and hopefully a fantastic atmosphere. So can't wait for this one. We really need to get behind our lads, because we're currently third in the table, and, you know, if we are to go up the seas, we need some big attendances. So yes, so far so good for the Blues. Hopefully get another win on Monday, which would be another real statement of intent. There's no time to cry. Stefan, I will be going to the match on Monday, so stay tuned for a match day preview, which will be out tomorrow. And of course, on Monday, we'll do a match day vlog for the Hereford game as well. So, wow, what a win today! Let's keep it going, Blues. Kidderminster is a really tough place to go, so once again, this is a massive statement of intent. So, of course, I am sure you enjoyed today's match day vlog. Please like, subscribe, and comment down your thoughts on the match below. So, yeah, see you on Monday. What a win! Come on, you Blues, let's keep on going. Get in.